So tell me, everybody's saying the tone a little darker, a little deeper this time. Mm-hmm. Do you feel it's changed like that?
Well, it you know, when you do a movie, you have a lot more latitude. It's not crazy dark. Like, it still has a PG-13 rating, so it doesn't get to a point where a lot of people can't see it, you know, young people. But, yeah, the world that Joss Whedon created is kind of a harsh world, you know. The government is not really your friend. And we're renegades kind of fighting this really bad group of people. So with bad people come bad things. And that's what this movie's about, is sort of you kind of see the underbelly of this bad government that we've been fighting all along.
Now, in Firefly, your character wanted to actually go out and get into the action a couple times. Do you get to do that in Serenity?
You know, in Serenity the movie, the action is following us. We aren't seeking it out as much as can't get away from it. So as long as you're on the spaceship, you're in the action. And since I fly it, I'm right there. I've got a good window view of it coming down.
And do we see more of the love story in Serenity? Do we see more of the background between you two?
And my wife and I? No, you do not. No. That is a shame about the TV show being canceled, because you have a lot of time to investigate all of those types of things. And in the movie, because we're also introducing these characters in this world to a whole new group of people who didn't know the series, it was mainly about, it's kind of the action. The action's happening around, and you know, you steal a kiss here or there, but you don't get into the depths of our relationship.
Would you like to see Serenity 2 and 3, or would you rather see Firefly come back?
I'd rather see Serenity 2 and 3, because I think that's what Joss Whedon wants, and as long as that's what he wants, I think that's what he's going to get, because that's what he said when we got canceled, is this is going to keep going, and it has.
Well, they never even gave you guys a shot, you know. So why do you think a sci-fi western didn't catch on? What do you think it was that people weren't kind connecting with?
The idea that it was a sci-fi western probably is where people were disconnecting. I mean, you know, people have gotten accustomed to one form of science fiction. And when you don't have aliens and when you don't have all these things, and wait a minute, there's horses and using bullets and there's no lasers, this isn't my version of sci-fi or my education in sci-fi. So it would take people who actually care to sit down and learn something, a new world. And because it did get such an odd introduction through the network that we were on, where our first episode, the pilot was shelved until the end, which introduced the whole... So that it really... We felt like we were on an uphill battle the whole way. And we just cherished every moment we had together and became really close friends in the process. And it's paid off, really, I think, because that closeness kind of came across, and our love for the show and our spaceship and the ship came across, and our characters were fighting this totalitarian government who was really uncaring, and that kind of translated really nicely when you're at a studio that doesn't much care for you. So I'm just happy that here we are.